up, LG gang? Okay, hey guys, it is about, I always tell y'all the time, 5:19 p.m. I normally start like a noonish 1-2 o'clock on my wash day. So I'm gonna do a hot oil treatment with jojoba oil and a little peppermint oil, just because my ends are cut and I haven't washed my hair in like 2 weeks, especially after my trim. So I'm gonna really, really get the strengthening back, get it healthy, which it's already healthy. When I rub my fingers through it, I feel like it's really, really healthy. You know how you just feel like your fingers knows your hair best, you know? So yeah, my curls be popping. No matter what kind of product I use, it just like pow, pop. I'm really digging the Echo Gel wash and go, and I'm also digging the Not Today Detangler by Kinky Curling. But yeah, let's get started, guys. I've already plaited my hair in 6, 2, 4, and then 6 up top, so it'll be a lot easier for me to just get down to the nitty gritty. And I've already have a cup of hot water down here, and I have I've been having this sitting there for about a minute. It said a minute or two, and then this here is just the Queen Helen jojoba hot oil treatment for dry and brittle hair. And my hair is dry. It's not brittle, but the ends, I really want it to stay strengthened and healthy. And then here I have this in there too, my peppermint oil. So I'm gonna mix the two. And this is just only a little bit of peppermint oil, which I don't need a lot. I think I'm just gonna put it down my like little parts, and then put the jojoba oil actually on my scalp and in my hair. So let's get started, guys. I think I'm gonna use, I don't know if I'm gonna use the whole thing. They said for short hair, use half, but I don't know. Let's see what to do. All right, guys, first and foremost, well, second, I have two things. One, this lipstick I have on my lips, it is true matte, because I've been trying to scrub my lips, trying to take it off, and nothing's really coming off. Yeah, so if y'all see like a tint on my lips, then that's what it is. Yeah, I took some pictures earlier, so yeah. No, Kelly be telling me, stop doing that, Mom. Moms don't do that. Stop doing that, Mom. I'm like, I don't know. But second of all, I've really, really, really been digging Amanda Seales and her outspokenness, her realness, her trueness, and everything, her women empowerment, everything. I love her. And if you guys follow me on social media, I have been talking about Amanda Seales' book. Go copy out her book. I have not received it yet, but all the reviews and everything is just giving it like thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up. They love it. I'm getting mine hopefully this weekend. I have been saying that the last 2 weekends, and I've been crazy busy. And I haven't had time to go pick it up, because once Monday hit, it's a wrap, period. So I do listen to her podcast, so that's what I'm going to be listening to throughout this video. So here we go.
I've been in front of this many white people since a congressional hearing. Hello, hello. Welcome to Small Doses, and it only seems right that we hit you with the theme song. This is our first ever Small Doses Live. So this is a seminal moment, so thank you to Clusterfest for giving us the opportunity to do this thing here. For those of you who don't know, Small Doses is a podcast that I do that I just described in that catchy jingle as self-help from the hip. But essentially, really, it's just me talking about different shit. So every episode, we have a side effects of. Okay, so we've done a bevy of side effects of. Side effects of fuckboys. I know y'all know about that. Side effects of white women. We've done side effects of being a cancer. It's cancer season! Everybody start crying. Yeah, the tears, they're coming. And by the way, I read a horoscope that said cancer season for cancers this year is gonna be a bitch. So, deal with that. There's 2 eclipses, and apparently eclipses mean chaos. So, it's gonna be so fun. But we'd like to do topics that are universal, and even if they're not universal, that, like, even if you're not necessarily dealing with it yourself, that somebody else you know is dealing with, or that just basically are within the zeitgeist of just being a human in this world. So that is how we function here at Small Doses. Today's episode, and I don't even think our guest knows that this is the topic. Do you know what the topic is?
No.
Yes! Today's episode is side effects of being a workaholic. He just said, God damn it. So, first of all, let me just say this. The whole workaholic thing, before we even go further, I think that there is definitely an idea that that was just like a little fun term. You know, that people would say, like, oh my God, I'm like such a workaholic, oh my God. But then it's become like an actual addiction. You know, people definitely use work to like get over anxiety, to deal with anxiety, to escape, to avoid, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so we have to acknowledge that we are now like in this space where work has become not just about like getting a job done to get funds, but also simply just about like a device that you're using to not deal with some other shit that you need to be dealing with. So you're like, you know, instead of working on that, I'm gonna just go over here and do this work. And that becomes a problem. So we're gonna talk about that. But before we talk about that with our guests, we're gonna do a little segment called Gem Dropping. Gem Dropping. Gem Dropping. Damn, drop it. We dropping mommy's hoes. Today's gem dropping. I feel like y'all need that again. So today's gem dropping is workaholic versus hard worker. Okay? Comparing the two and breaking it down. Now, when we talk about somebody who is a hard worker, that's somebody that's really just getting it in, you know, that's committed to their work ethic, that really is just making sure that they're handling their end of the bargain in whatever job that they have signed up to do, or in whatever path they signed up to do, right? So, like, I know a lot of us are out here on the grind. We hustling. We trying to get it in. I like y'all because you be nodding like, yeah, yeah, yeah. The rest of y'all are looking at me like, I thought this was a comedy show. There'll be jokes. Just, we got to drop some jams first, as the jingle suggested. So,
alright, so I put it in the six, guys. Bam.
You know who really loves fresh
food? So now,
amateur
turn
chefs.
That down until her podcast comes back on. Goodness. Okay, so with me detangling, here's my hair. I don't think there was any. Oh, there's one more. Little piecey piece. Okay, this is how much hair I lost. Not bad. Not bad to not have washed it in 2 weeks. Okay, so this peppermint oil. Boom. I'm going to just put it on my scalp just to kind of open my pores, get that going.
Coming to the stage.
Ooh, that feels good.
This is the thing about my show, is that I only have people on my show that I like. Later in the show, we're going to do a segment called People I Like. Because I didn't want there to be any confusion. I don't want nobody hitting me like, damn, like, how come I ain't been on your show? I don't
Okay, I'm just going to use the rest of this for my crown because that's where the most breakage is, right on my crown. There. All right, oh, a little bit more. Okay, so right now, feeling good, feeling great. I'm about to put my shower cap on, go warm my hot head, place my hot head on for about 15, 20 minutes. I'm gonna do a little bit of editing and finish listening to Amanda Seals. Ooh, the oil is dripping. Amanda Seals podcast, Small Doses, and get back with you guys. Right now, I'm just going to put my shower cap on just so the oils and stuff won't be running down on my ear and my face and everything. Put that all up in there. There you go. Okay, so I'm about to go warm this up, guys. Same thing. 45 seconds flip and then 45 seconds and then just place on the head. Be right back.
Gryffindor. I was sorted into Gryffindor for years, you know, just out of courageousness and bravery. Mm-hmm. And then I got older and realized that I needed not work harder. I needed to work smarter. And now all of a sudden, I was procrastinating from doing what I needed to be doing.
Which is 20 minutes, guys.
Which is actually coming out in
October. Oh, and while this is going, I have my timer going about 20 minutes.
And I went to Pottermore.
I am going to... actually, I'm going to try this. I'm just going to try it. I was going to give it a thought, but I was just going to try it because whenever I shampoo my hair with this, now since I used to love it. I don't know what's going on now with my hair, but every time I shampoo my hair with this, my hair feels extra dry afterwards. And I'm not sure what's going on. So, I've seen this YouTuber, Jay Mayo. If you haven't subscribed to her, go check her out. She's another natural girl, 4C girl. She actually used the leave-in conditioner first and then didn't rinse it out, but then chased it with the shampoo. And she said her hair came back, you know, really healthy. It seemed hydrated, things like that. So I'm going to do it like that today. I'm going to go ahead and put this on it first and then chase it with this. I might even mix the two. Hell, I don't know. But I'm just going to do it like she's doing it because I don't want to try no different tricks and then my hair be looking all crazy. So I'm going to do this, put this all over my hair, get it in there good, don't rinse it out, and then chase it with this, and I'll be back with y'all. After the 20 minutes, I'm going to shampoo or condition. Do the leave-in conditioner, the restore, and then the shampoo, and then I'll be back with y'all. Ooh. All right, guys. Sorry. All right, guys. I took a little nap, an unexpected nap. It is now 8:07. Yeah, I took like probably an hour nap. I didn't even feel myself going to sleep, but I cannot fall asleep with this hot oil treatment. In my hair, I shouldn't have left it in so long, but who cares? But this is what it looks prior to washing it out. This is what it looks like. Oh, nice and juicy. Look at that. Okay. Nice and juicy, nice and healthy. Look at my ends. There's no like scraggly things. This is the back there. All right, guys, like I said, I'm going to go in with the Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil Strengthening and Restore Leave-In Conditioner first. And then I am not going to wash that out. And then I'm going to go in and chase it with the Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil Strengthening and Restore Shampoo. And then I'm going to towel dry. So when you guys see me next, I should be having a towel on my head. So here we go. All right, guys, let's get it together here. All right, I'm coming back with the leave-in conditioner, y'all. I used like a scoop to put it in prior to the shampoo. But this is what I'm working with. I towel dried. And this is it. Yeah, my curls. Ooh. Okay, so this is what I'm working with. I grabbed my water bottle just to kind of soak it. I didn't plan on doing this or filming this, but I'm going to film it anyway. I got my rollers. I'm going to try it out. Trying a new roller set there. So I have my purple ones. They're kind of like a medium size here. Yeah, little roller set. Bam. So I'm going to start with the back. I'll probably do two on camera just to show you guys what I'm doing. And then do the rest off camera. So, see if that's like no way in the middle, but it's fine. I'm not trying to make it just perfect. I don't think when you're dealing with natural hair, you can't be a perfectionist. Like, you just got to go with the flow a little bit. Because you kind of don't, well, for me, I kind of don't know how, just because I plan on doing it, you know, one way, or have a vision for my hair one way, it could totally turn out different, you know. So for the back, I pinned that up, but for the back, I'm just going to finger part. Just to kind of, and the reason why I pin that up is because just to kind of get it out the way. Okay, so then I'm just going to get this out the way too. There. Alright, so now I'm going to put my towel on just because I'm going to drench my hair. Well, spray it, drench it, whatever. Where my little clip go? Bam! Here it is. Alright, so I'm just gonna grab a little section. I'll probably do three in the back. Pin this over. I'll just grab this because I don't got another one. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna spray it just to kind of get some more moisture in there. There we go. And then fingle detangle, which I've detangled it prior, and then I detangled it while I was washing. So I'm going over it with this comb here. And it's all detangled. So now I'm going to go in with the leave-in. And I'm only going to use about that much of the leave-in. I even think that that's way too much, but I don't know. Yeah. Hopefully it dries. I'm going to run it through like the blow dryer after I get done. So after I do, yeah, I think I put too much on that one. Oh, well. So after I do that and then just kind of comb through it, I think I'm going to chase it with one of these small tooth combs just so I can make sure that all of the little kinks are out. Although it is pretty out when my hair is dry, it's even better when it combs through it. So I'm just gonna put a little, I don't know why I can't talk while I'm doing this. Yes, okay. So I'm gonna put one of my rollers in. There you go. And then just gonna pull it around and lock it in place. That's a little loose. Hold on. Because I want it tight. I don't want no, I don't know if I can do it real tight, but I don't want any, like, loose. Yeah, so that is tight, but, and they said go over. Oh, yeah, well, that makes sense. Yeah, now it's tight. Bam! Okay, so I'm gonna do the back. It is hot.
Come into this past. Oh, time just keep on thinking back.
Okay, here's the three back there. So I'll see you guys in a minute. Alright guys, my last one, and I just kind of wanted to show you guys. It's a little dry. It already put the conditioner in there. I think it needs a little bit more on the end. But I already put everything in there. I'm just going to comb it through. Just make sure everything is righty-tighty. There we go. So, yeah. So I'm just going to go to the end. Grab my purple roller, roll it, and then roll it up. Try your luck. Be in touch. Okay, so if y'all are not used to the roller set, make sure you pin it down and go on top so your curl can be a little bit more tighter. See? Ooh, that's a little too tight. Okay. Ooh, it's pulling one hair. Ow! There we go. Okay, so that is it, and yeah, guys, I'm going to let it air dry a little bit. Going to let it air dry a tad, and then I'm going to take a blow dryer to it just to kind of help it dry, and none of them are, like, super loose. They're just right and tight in there. I think I got about 18 rollers in. So this is the back, and like I said, I don't care about straight lines. So this is the back here and the front. And guys, I just used the water and the leave-in conditioner, rolled it up, and bam. Yeah, so I'm just gonna let it air dry a little bit, and then I'll probably include you guys in or whatever, or record as I blow dry. So see you in a bit. Alright guys, this is it. Good night, good night, good night. I am tired. Hopefully, with me blow drying it a little bit, it will dry before the morning. I hate taking out my rollers and figuring out that it's still damp because it makes my hair a hot mess. But I will show you guys in the morning before I go to work what it's looking like. So, catch me tomorrow morning. Murder scene, Cardi made.
worth and it won't be for long. I ain't having it. You don't do the shit that you said will be done. You find it fun to feel shit and run. Love like a gun, it leaves me stunned. Out on the floor and I just can't get up. And I don't know why I'm even still here. Can't shake it off. I've been here for years on top of it.
It was a fail. I don't know. All this work. Let me see what it looked like to when I pick it out. I don't know. The top didn't curl like I wanted it to. Like, all like this. Yeah, I don't even know if I can work with this. Look like a clown. Guess I can wear like a big fro. Does this look bad?
It doesn't look like you. But I've seen it before.
It's just like a big fro, but I'm gonna wear it. Rocking my fro today.